Gwasfestwrddw. That's where we are. Gwasfestwrddw. Good morning, everybody. Welcome to my channel and welcome to my first vlog in a Class 1 vehicle in over half a year. I realise you can't see me. Where's the light switch? There we go. Hello. Yes, we are in my new truck, my new DAF 105 XF Superspace. And yeah, first day at the job, I thought I'll vlog it. Why not? Now it is dark. It's half past five in the morning right now, but just before half five, and we need to get it going. So let's take the handbrake off. Let's put the red lights on a second. I think you can still see me a little bit. But yeah, I won't talk for long because obviously it's dark out, and you obviously can't see me very much. So there's no point doing it too much. And away we go. So we are now on the open road, driving Class 1 truck for the first time in 6 months. We are going to a Monmouth in Wales, and then Port Talbot in Wales. They're two places we're going to. Got to get used to these pedals because the brake is quite close. It feels like it's really close to the accelerator. So that's going to take some getting used to. But yeah, here we go. Anyway, I'm going to turn the cameras off and concentrate on driving for a little bit, and I see you when we're a little bit closer to our first job. See you in a bit. Okay, you join me about an hour later. It's now half past six in the morning, and we're just going over Severn Bridge. Well, it used to be Severn Bridge. It's now Prince of Wales Bridge, isn't it? So we're going into Wales. Just going to get over into lane one. Yeah, I think I've been saying the word that we're going to, the place we're going to wrong. Scott Andrews has been telling me off. I think I've been saying a Monford. I think it's a Manford. I think that's what they say. I think I might be getting it wrong still. A Manford. But yeah, we've got 25 bags for them, then we've got 20 bags for Port Talbot later. I've been talking to Scott, and he's been to both of these places, and so he's given me some directions and stuff to get in, so very handy of him. Apparently the Port Talbot one can be a bit of a nightmare, so looking forward to that. But he's also told me there's a McDonald's at the end of the M4, 50% off because Monday was that eat in, eat out thing. Now you can see me, now you can see the truck a little bit better. I've got my bedding with me, but I've not got my bed set up yet, so that's got to be done at some point. Not necessarily today, but at some point it needs to be done. The only thing I really need to do now is bring some clothes to work. I've been told that I am home tonight, so I'd have to bring some clothes in tomorrow, just in case we're on a night out. I keep getting asked, is this day work or tramp and work, and it's kind of like a bit of both. They're going to get me home if they can, which is ideal because we're only based around the corner from my house. But obviously if I can't get home, then I'll be on a night out. So yes, yeah, no, we're just traveling to Monmouth now. Scott says it's nice and easy, drive in, drive out, one way system, and looking on the Google Maps it looks like a massive site, so I'm not worried about that site at all in the slightest. It's the Port Talbot one I'm worried about. Looks like I'm going to be doing some sort of reversing manoeuvre, and because I've been off of this for the past sort of 6 or 7 months driving Class 1s, then reversing manoeuvres are going to be new to me again. I mean, hopefully we'll be alright, but we will see. And I don't know what they're like with regards to filming either, so I doubt I'll be able to film too much inside the yard, but yeah, we'll see about that. We will see. But yeah, no, for now, let's just crack on. Still got another hour and a half at least before we get to Monmouth. ETA there for about 8:15. So yeah, let's go. Let's get cracking. See you in a bit. You only make you feel-
feel like you could never leave. Do the same, we can't go back, this is all we need. Follow me to make believe and make your dreams come true. This night means forever and so does me and you. We say we love, we say we love.
Okay, you join me about a mile and a half away from our first destination. And, yeah, the first chance that we're going to get to actually test my class one driving abilities, going around roundabouts and tight corners and things like that. So, it's going to be fun. Got to try and remember all my angles. Lovely jubbly. Yeah, just got to try and not do any curbing or anything like that. You definitely could have gotten if you put your foot down. Thank you very much. So yeah, this job, the first one we're going to, looks like it's going to be nice and easy. It's just going to be a case of driving in, driving out, as I've already said. It's the next one I'm a little bit worried about, but we'll cross that bridge when we get there. In terms of driving time, I reckon I can get both drops off before needing a break, and then try and get somewhere and have a break, and then I think we're heading back then to get reloaded somewhere, I'm not sure. And then maybe done for the day. Could be quite an early finish today, I don't know. Got no idea what's going on. No idea. Just do as I'm told. But yeah, we're going to a company called, I think it's called LBC, Builders Merchants. I've never heard of them before. So maybe they're just like a Wales thing. I got no idea. Maybe they are, maybe they're not. We need to do a right hand turn. Is it this right here? Yeah, it is. According to the sat nav, oh yeah, LBS, that's it, not LBC, LBS. I'm going to take up both lanes so I can take it nice and wide. So like I said, I'm still learning my angles again. I've not messed up yet, so that's good. LBS, Builders Merchants, LBS. They've got lots of signs out. There's another burger van there. Scott did tell me about that burger van as well. There's loads of burger vans in Wales. and the sat-nav postcode took me to this road a little bit further down, but I believe we've got to take a left turn here. Yeah, there's a sign there that says LBS left. Yeah, the sat-nav postcode took me further on down this road, so turn left here, loads of room. Don't hit the curb, excellente. Fair play, they got loads of signs up. There's a lot of housing around here, a lot of housing estates. So they obviously don't want trucks going down the wrong way. And that's an LBS lorry, which is coming straight round. Cheers for waiting, mate. He wasn't slowing down, was he? That's a good sign. That means we are heading in the right direction. Ooh, a bit of wheel spinach. I was told that these DAF XFs, 105s XFs, I was told that they pull quite well. It's pulling. It's pulling well. Give it that. Okay, and here we go. So I think that's the way out there. We want to go in this way. Fingers crossed, it'll be straight in, unload, and straight out. Fingers crossed. Right. So yeah, I'm going to turn the cameras off now because I don't want to be filming too much inside. Which entrance do I take? That's a good question. I want to take the right here, I think. I'm pretty sure. I love how the Arctic can turn around a lot easier as well. I might be in the wrong way. Never mind. Anyway, I'll see you in a bit. Okay, we are offloaded. 25 bags off. Took a little bit longer than expected. But, you know, that's just how it goes sometimes. Well, there wasn't a queue or anything like that. I was straight in. You know, I don't know, like it took 5 minutes or so for me to get the curtains open and get the straps off, ready to go. Just where they had to take it, really. And yeah, a bit awkward getting the top rail off because they were double stacked, because we've got a low roof on this trailer, so they struggled getting the top rail off. So I think that's probably why it took a little bit of time, but yeah, we're out there anyway now. It's 20 past nine currently. We are now gonna head straight to our second drop, which is about 45 minutes away. So should be there, bit of luck, by like 10 past 10, something like that. And then hopefully we can get that offloaded quite quickly and then go find somewhere to park up on the way back towards the M5 we've got to go. We've got to go to Portbury Docks to reload. So we'll head back on the M4 and park in one of the services, I suspect, get a 45 minute break. And then go to Portbury Docks. That car's indicating left. I don't know what we're getting loaded with. I don't even know where we're getting loaded in Portbury Docks. All I know is Portbury Docks to reload for tomorrow. So once that's done, I'll be done for the day. Need to sneeze. Bless me. So yeah, I've done nearly 3 hours driving. So by the time I get to this place, I'll have 45 minutes of drive time remaining, which should be more than enough time to find somewhere to park up. I'd be very surprised if I struggled to find somewhere to park up. And that was the burger van that Scott mentioned. Apparently it's really good. All right, let's go around here. Are we clear? We're clear. Right, foot down. Like I said, we've taken 25 bags off now, so we've got less than half the weight that we did have before, so fuel economy is going to be a little bit better, and we might be able to go up the hills a bit faster because we were crawling up some of the hills. And I might need to get fuel at some point as well. We've got just over half a tank of fuel, so I might get some fuel on the way back. Maybe Chippenham truck stop, I don't know. We'll see. But yeah, anyway, let's make our way to our second job. Ooh, look at that rain! We be in Wales. I'm glad I brought my coat. I got my coat, that's good. I'm wearing shorts. I did bring some high-vis trousers as well. I reckon I might be getting change into them. Right, we want to get on over. I'm going to be getting on over. Right, so this is Port Talbot. And I'm hoping we don't have to reverse off a roundabout, which is what Scott said. Sometimes he's been asked to do that, but he's always refused. Apparently his company always tell him no, they are not reversing off the roundabout because it's not legal to do that. But apparently they may ask about it, I don't know. We'll soon find out. Bam, 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 bam. Left is clear, right is clear. Yeah, it was sunny just now, and then all of a sudden, the rain just poured down out of nowhere. Good news is we've only got 20 bags to come off. They're all on the front, and I might be able to just climb up inside the trailer to keep, like, not fairly dry, to just open up the ears with a stick while inside the trailer. It's probably what I'm going to do. Right, where are we? Gotta go left here. Yeah, it's confusing because on Google Maps it quite clearly shows like you go around the back of this place, and also the paperwork says go around the, well, it doesn't say go around the back, but the street is on the back. It doesn't say this road, and yeah, it's up there, look, on the right. So I'm hoping there's no trucks in there, we can just kind of like pull on in. That's what I'm hoping. Huh. go, LBS. And in we go. Hazards on. And oh, there's a truck here, look. There's a side over there, it's very close. Right, I need to find out what's happening, because I haven't got a clue. Be right back. Okay, we're just leaving Port Talbot Job now. Bit of a palaver. It was quite busy in here, and so we had to do one side first, and then I was in people's way, then I had to move so they can do the other side, and it was just one of those situations where everyone is in everyone's way. And I got drenched. Right, hazards off. He's indicating left. Okay. Yeah, so, second job done. So we're now empty. Second steering wheel was quick then. Yeah, so we're now empty. I haven't had a text yet telling me what I'm collecting, but I have had a text saying it's from Portbury Docks, so which is in Bristol, which is an hour and 20 minutes away. Plus, I still need to get a brake in. I'm on 3 hours, 40 minute driving. I can do 4.5. So I've got 50 minutes of drive time left. However, I did start work at 5:30 this morning, so I need to stop. No, I don't. I don't need to stop at half. You're supposed to, because it's 6 hour working time. So I'm confusing myself now. I don't need to stop because I managed to get a 15 minute break in earlier at my first job before they offloaded me. And I got there for 8 o'clock, 8:15-ish. So let's just say 8 o'clock, it was later than 8 o'clock. Let's say 8 o'clock, so it's 6 hours from 8 o'clock. So it's 9, 10, 11, 12, 1, 2. So I have to have a half an hour break before 2 o'clock this afternoon, which is in 3 hours time, or within 50 minutes of drive time. So whichever comes first. So basically 50 minute drive time. So I'm gonna basically go onto the M4 and stop in the services somewhere. Don't quite know which one yet. Probably, I guess the only one is, well, the only ones are in Wales, isn't it? So I'll probably stop in the last one in Wales. Can't remember what it's called. And then go to Bristol from there. Or Portbury Docks. Oh, I might. No, I can't. I can't make Gordano. I won't have enough time to get to Gordano. I'm just talking to myself now. Anyway, yeah, I got soaking wet. Wearing shorts, but I did remember my coat. It's in my side locker now because it's drenched. It's been in my car for ages. And I got to work this morning. I packed my bed in, and I packed some stuff in a bag that I needed to bring to the truck with me. So like electrical cables and sat nav and stuff like that. And I opened up the boot of my car this morning. It was pitch black. I had my torch. And it's only because the shiny bit on the high-vis like shined. I was like, I'll take that just in case. Bloody good job I did. I bought some trousers. You'd probably just about make them out as well, because I'm wearing shorts at the moment. So I bought some orange high-vis trousers with me as well, just in case. But I never felt the need to put them on. So anyway, yeah, lovely Wales. It's nice and wet and rainy. And it's not windy, but it's just wet and miserable. So great first day. Great first day. No, in all seriousness, today's not gone too bad. I got both my drops off before 11 a.m, so that's good. We're now completely empty and just need to head back now, get reloaded, and then done for the day. Unless they ask me to deliver it today, because if all goes to plan, I'll be there for 1 o'clock. I don't know how long it takes to load, but say an hour, that's 2 o'clock, and then I'll be back in the yard like 3:30, 4. So we'll see. Anyway, see you in a bit. Okie dokie then, time for a break. We didn't quite reach the one by the M4, which is Magnor. We're at Grasfestodrw. That's where we are. never been in here before. So services, Grasfestodrw is just over here. And we got 20 minutes of drive time left still. So yeah, it's about, I think it's another sort of 35, maybe 40 minutes away to that Magnor. So we're just shy of driver time to get there, so I thought we'd stop here instead. Nice and safe. And don't want to be going over my driving time on my first day. I've just got a message coming through as well. We are getting loaded at Royal Portbury Docks. But I think it says loading tomorrow. I'm not sure. So I need to find out whether that is loading tomorrow or loading tonight. Or is it could be a night out before getting loaded. I don't know. And also says delivery for 2 p.m. tomorrow, which is like very late in the day. That would mean a very late start. So these are just things I need to iron out with the boss, because I don't want to be doing anything wrong. But for now, we need to have a break, so that's what we're going to concentrate on. Like I said, I've never been in here, so I don't know whether the lorry's parked. There's a lorry in front of me, so I will be keeping an eye out for him. He's gone on the left. Yeah, I guess so. There we go, lorry's right. Lovely jubbly. Just got to find somewhere to park. Looks like loads of room. That's nice. Somewhere where I haven't got to do any reversing would be nice. Just as I'm getting used to driving the truck. Where's the way out? That's the way out. Oh, okay. Okay, that's cool. That's cool. That's cool. We will park here next to him. Straighten up. That'll do, donkey. That will do. Handbrake on, neutral, engine off. There we go. Right, I'm gonna have a break. Better put it on brake before I forget. There we go. Let's chill out for about half an hour. Oh, message. Report is this: we are in Royal Portbury Dock. The curtains are open, and I've given them a reference. We're just waiting for a forklift driver to tell me where to go. This could be it.
Go on, mate.
Yeah.
Work down there for me.
Drive down, yeah. Yeah, all right, mate. I think he wants me to drive down. Do you want me to drive down, yeah? Drive down it, yeah. Yeah, all right, mate. Because there is a one-way symbol, that's all, so I just don't want to mess it up, do you know what I mean? But yeah, we drive down this way. He'll have to say when he wants me to stop, because I don't know what I'm taking. I think it's these crates, I think. Just stop here. There's someone on the left of me now, so see what he says. I think that's good. I think they're talking to each other. They're loading me both sides at the same time, simultaneously. I'll turn the engine off. Lovely. Lovely jubbly. We're in drive still. So I don't know how we get out of here. I guess we go down there. I don't know. No idea. Right, I'm gonna get loaded. I'll see you in a bit. Right, we are fully loaded now with crates of slate. We've got a full load. Well, I say full load. I think we can probably take some more, but we got 20 crates worth, and each crate is I don't know. Total weight is 24.5 ton, so of the load, not including my net weight or my tire weight to make the net weight, you know what I mean. But yeah, we're underweight either way. we're heading back towards the yard now, but I do need to get some fuel because we're on just under half, so yeah, I could probably do just getting some just to be safe. There we go. But I've never been to Chippenham pit stop before to get fuel, so it's all new to me. I got a fuel card, I got a pin. Hopefully it all works. that's the plan anyway. So yeah, I think that's going to be it for today. Like I said, because I'm going back to the yard now, so that's it. It's only 2 o'clock in the afternoon, so time to fill up the fuel and get back to the yard. We're probably talking like 3:30, 4:15. It's quite early, so. But it's only my first day. It's not going to be like that every day, I know that. So we'll take this as a good first day, nice and easy first day. And I'm sure some hard work is going to come soon. All right, let's get on over. Anyway, thanks for watching. I do appreciate it. Stay safe, drive safe, and I'll see you soon. Bye-bye.